Super Enforcer, Mr. California!
Welcome to another edition of Ultra Violent Radio. I am your host, the one and only, the hardcore enforcer, Mr. California. I like to refer myself as the master of ultra violence these days. But right before we get to our guest right now in a few minutes, I'd like to throw a little shout out there to the boys of the Santino Boys Academy. Because next week, on Saturday night, they're going to do a show April 9th to my trainer. Rest in peace, so legendary Mr. 80s Dynamite D. And we're going to have on next week Chaos, too, so he can talk about the show and talk about his death matches and his, you know, his brutals, his violence and his all the stuff he's done in his school and stuff like that. So next Ultra Violent Radio audition, we're going to have him on Chaos. But now, live on the line with me, the one and only Spider Boobo. Are you there with me, brother?
I'm here, brother. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Now, how you doing, man, over there in Alabama? That's where you're from, aren't you, brother?
Yeah. I'm originally from Detroit, but I'm settled down here in Bama now, so.
Oh, okay. Hey, brother, well, you know what? Let's start off this interview with your name, man. How'd you get the name Spider Boobo, brother?
Oh, shoot, man. When I was training, they were just looking at me, and I said, you kind of look like a convict in a way, and, you know, it started out like a convict gimmick, and they just thought of some names that people would be in a, you know, jail or something, you know, prison, and that's how Spider come across, and Boudreaux, man. Really that simple.
So how do you say the last name, Boudreaux?
It's sort of supposed to have been more like a Louisiana, like Boudreaux, but then I kind of broke off of with an X and started with a double O and a W.
Oh, Boudreaux. All right, that's cool, man. That's crazy, man. Yeah, because you have a unique name, brother. You know what I mean? For a death network, I mean, you know, they got weird names these days, like the Freak Show, Deranged, Mr. Insanity, you know what I mean? Madman Pondo, stuff like that. But your name stands out there, brother. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? You know, you're from the deep south area. And when I heard your name, I was like, oh, man, this sounds crazy. You know what I mean? And I seen a couple of your matches, you know what I'm saying?
I appreciate it, man. I try, at least.
Yeah, so let's get right into this, brother, moving on this interview. 2011 Carnage Cup, man, it just happened in February, man. For the people that like death matches, go to www.smartmarkvideo.com and get yourself a copy. It's a good death match. You did the first ever Saw death match. Am I correct, brother? Out here in the States, man. Is that correct?
That's what I hear. Me and John Rare did it here in the United States.
Yeah, because, I mean, it was done once in Germany, but, I mean, here in the United States, it was never done to you. You did it at the Carnage Cup, man.
Right.
Yeah, and then I was asking you, I put a YouTube tape, brother. You know, when I was advertising you on the flyer and advertising you on Facebook, on the message boards up here, man. And I put a YouTube tape when what was the guy's name again? The guy you wrestled again, brother?
At the Corners Cup.
Yeah,
it's John Rare.
John Rare. Okay, I really don't know who he is. John Rare. He got like a box cutter or Zacto knife, brother, and he sticked it in your left arm, brother, and it just started pouring like a fountain, man. Just tell us how that feel and what made you do that. You know what I'm saying, brother?
Man, it stung. I mean, I ain't gonna lie, but going into it, I just wanted to do something that'd be rememberable. So I told him, you know, let's do it. Let's go for it. I wasn't trying to disrespect nobody or do nothing wrong,
yeah.
You know, just entertain the fans. And, hell, from what I got from it, they were entertained. There's some that don't like it, but, I mean, anything you do in this business ain't gonna be liked by everybody.
Yeah, exactly, man. You know, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta try to be innovative and try to do something different. Because you know, hardcore is a lot of people. It's every kind of deathmatch has been done already. You know, like in Big Japan, they've done everything. Out here in the States, they try to do almost everything. And you gotta try to innovate it. You know what I mean? Because there's syringes, there's barefooted thumbtack matches, and you know, you try to innovate. I mean, I've seen box cutters, but that's the first time I ever seen it, I guess someone get stabbed, and that was pretty sick, man. And I mean, I like that, man. You know, I give you props and respect you for that, man.
Hey, I appreciate it, man. I appreciate it, dude. I just, like I said, as long as me and the guy I'm working comes out fine and the fans are happy, that's all I worry about.
Yeah, I was going to tell you, I was going to ask you, what kind of weapons did you have in that Saw Deathmatch, if you can tell me, brother?
Oh, man, they had razor blade boards, razor blade table, push pin boards and table, and a bat with push pins on it. You know, it was all right. it was really you know, a lot of mental going into it, because you know you don't want to get cut real bad, but the box cutter I guess took that over.
Yeah, because the saw. Yeah, I see you guys go up at, like, in the venue. There was like a soda machine, wasn't it?
And yeah, it was a like a Coke machine, Pepsi machine, something, and he gave me a sidewalk slam on it, and
missed the table
just about and hit my head.
Almost cracked your head open, huh, brother? That's what it was.
Yeah, I couldn't breathe for about 2 minutes, man.
Yeah, I see that, man. I have the DVD, man, and I see when you picked you up. And he barely picked you up, but it still looks sick, brother. You know what I mean? It still looks sick, man.
I appreciate it.
When he smashed you through it. And what does it tell you? Hey, but did you lose a lot of blood out of your arm, man, when he stabbed you with
that? Yeah, I lost quite a few. Like I said, I had done it before, you know, the stabbing, but not as bad as that one looked. But the medical personnel there, you know, I had a good friend there too, and they take me up quick, man, and it was all good. It's the healing process, you know, still a little bruise, but that's about it.
That's crazy. All right, brother, let's talk about Carnage Cup 2008, man. When you did, I think it was the first round match, you did I have the DVD right here, a Devil's Playground death match, is that correct?
Right, against Psycho.
He's
a good friend. He's from Alabama also.
Yeah, you guys kind of went stiff in the beginning, man, of the match. You know what I mean? And to tell the fans, brother, that don't know, you know, all these smart marks that I like to call, that people don't know, what is a Devil's Playground deathmatch, man? If you can tell us, you know what I mean?
Just basically the way it sounds, just different weapons of all kinds. You know, just mostly the bookers putting them in there. You know, whatever they feel. You know, just about everything that's in a deathmatch.
Yeah, and then I like the ending, man. When you went over and you won the match, when you guys went on top of the U-Haul truck and you guys flamed a table on fire and you put him like a Takamichi driver, man, through it, man. That was pretty crazy, man.
Yeah, that's exactly what it was. That's what Swamp's finisher is. It's a rip of the Michinoku driver.
Yeah, like a driver. And what made when you were up in that U-Haul truck, Spider? What did you think? You just didn't think? You just went with it, or did you hesitate a little bit? Can you tell us, brother?
Ah, man, just went with it, man. It was one of the easiest drops I've done. I've come off a building onto a van with a guy before doing the same maneuver, a real good friend of mine. So, I mean, the fire was kind of new, but I felt that we had it.
Yeah, then you won the match, and then you went on to the finals, and you wrestled a guy that I had been in a ring with before, my name was the Freak Show, brother. You know what I mean?
Good guy.
Yeah, he is a good guy. I like the Freak Show. Freak Show's a good guy. A lot of good things to say about Freak Show. I've been in the ring with them. We had a really bloody match, and that was good. But enough about me. Let's talk about you, Spider. You guys had a garden death match? What was it? What kind of match was it?
Yeah, they had all different kinds of stuff, like from the garden out there, like a... You know, they had hoes and, like, little saws, and I had a fan out there. And
I was about to tell you that right now. I had a fan, and then it had even, like, a bill. What is it, those things you put flowers in them, you know?
Yeah.
I forgot what it was, but you guys had, I think he gave you a sidewalk slam, and you gave him a sidewalk slam on one of those barrels or whatever it was.
Yeah, he did it to me.
And you came out just short, brother. He beat you, man. And I mean, that could have been you going to the finals, man. You know what I mean? But man, that's what I did see, Spider. That dogs you. The Carnage Cup is done. When are you gonna win this thing? What do you think you're gonna get your shot at winning this Carnage Cup, man?
Man, I don't know. I'm gonna try it one more year if Kevin's still gonna have it, and I'm pretty sure he is. And then you know I'm getting kind of old, so maybe this last year, I hope.
Yeah, because, I mean, how many have you been? You've been in what? That was your third one?
This would be my third one, but I've wrestled with Kevin. You know, he's had different venues. But this is my third
Carnage Cup.
Third Carnage Cup, yeah.
That's crazy. You know what? Because the Carnage Cup, man, is considered one of the most deadliest, craziest fucking tournaments, man. You know, you have the TOD, of course. You have the King of the Death matches. You have the Masters of Pain, brother, and you have all these other kind of tournaments, you know what I mean? But the Carnage Cup, if you remember, Spider, back in 2007 when Freak Show won the Carnage Cup, three wrestlers got injured in that tournament, and they got the reputation of being one of the most violent tournaments in history.
Yeah, that's what I heard. And my boy Freak Show, you know, come on top, and props to him. And,
yeah.
You know, he's from this area, too, so, you know.
Yeah, I actually saw that. I was pretty crazy. Yeah, because I remember Greg Younger almost lost his ear, and Scotty Voices broke his hand, And then that guy Deranged broke his foot, man, off a freak. When you wrestle a freak show, you go, I think he was giving like a leg drop and he broke. And since that, the everybody's saying that if you enter the car, it's because you're going to die or something like that. You know what I mean? That's what I hear, you know. Yeah, it's a strong reputation, but you know what? That's what it is. It's a Carnage Cup, you know what I mean?
That's right. And you know what you're doing before you get in there. And anything can happen. So,
yeah,
you know, these are the toughest SOBs I've ever been in the ring with. And they deserve everything. You know, so my props to them.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, so how long you been wrestling, brother, if you could tell?
'99, going into 2000, going on a little bit, like, going on, what, 13 years maybe? 12 and a half.
And what's your, if you could tell, what is your worst injuries you ever had, man, and doing these deathmatch tournaments or deathmatches, you know?
I really hadn't got injured in the deathmatch, just in regular matches. Besides the box cutter, but it really didn't injure me. I busted my shoulder coming off the top rope, and nobody was there. And I hit the ground and busted my shoulder all the hell and back. And I got a screw in it at the moment. So, you know, I got a bum knee. It's numerous down. You know, I broke my jaw several times. That happens. But thank God it's no really major injury. I've just been out of business, you know, past couple of years on and off because of injuries.
I feel you, man. You know, I had myself too. I don't know, sick injuries, but I had, you know, several good gashes and nasty cuts. And I was okay. Yeah, well, we talked earlier before we got into this radio show, brother. You wrestled New Jack once, but twice, huh? Already, you told me before.
Right. Yeah, back in 2004.
And if you could tell me, brother, how was that experience wrestling New Jack, brother?
Oh, man, I mean, he was, like, the first big name, you know, it wasn't just, like, a regular name, you know, it was New Jack, so, shoot, you know, the stories, man, I was terrified. I gave him much respect, and actually, he's one of the coolest guys I have ever met in my life.
And you guys just did a regular New Jack match, or a hardcore match, just brawl and started?
Yeah, it was a three-way at first with me and him and a guy from around here named Prophet, and he won the title that night, and he come back a month later. And me and him had a real good match. He beat the shit out of me, but I went over on that one.
Oh, there you go. What did he beat you with?
You know, he just had, you know, just the forks, the fist, you know.
Yeah.
Just,
you know, I actually been in the ring with New Jack, man, and XPW, Cold Day in Hell, and I actually been with the original gangsters, Mustafa and New Jack, at the same time, and I know where you're coming from. I know how you feel when you get in the ring with New Jack, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. You tremble, man, but, you know, once you're cool with him, man, he's the best dude you ever met in your life.
Yeah. You pretty much go in there, like, you go, man, you hear the stories, like, hey, man, this guy's still, this guy's going to cut you, he stabbed, he's killed people, you know what I mean? But, you know, he's not really like that, man. He needs to take care of you if you do what you got to do in there, you know what I mean?
Oh, he's very professional to me, so I have much respect for him out of any worker I've ever been with.
Who else have you wrestled? I mean, I know you've done some sick death matches, and let's get to this topic, Spider. What is probably the sickest death match you've ever done? But I mean, was it the Saw death match?
Yeah, that's, you know, I've only done three or four of them, and that's probably the sickest one I've done.
Yeah, because I mean, when I saw everything, I mean, people literally pop when I put that YouTube video up, and they're saying like, oh, holy shit, ow, you know what I mean? How the fuck, you know what I mean? And
right, yeah, it's, like I said, a lot of people hate it, but, you know, a lot of people liked it, and as long as the fans are happy and the dude I worked, that's all that matters to me, so.
Exactly, and you know, you also told me that you wrestled, non-hardcore matches, you wrestled Big Daddy V, also known as Mabel, and what was his other gimmick name he said, WWE?
Oh, man, that's when he did it with the Taker, Viscera.
Viscera, there you go, brother. Thank you. Appreciate that.
Right,
you wrestled him as Big Daddy V, did you?
Yeah, he come in as, he wasn't Big Daddy V at the time. He was Viscera.
Yeah.
But I was like you at the time when we did that talk. That was the only name I could remember at the moment. But, yeah, it was Viscera at that time.
And then how was that match between you and him, man? Because he's a big
man.
Oh,
man, he's great. He's a good guy. I've seen him a couple years ago, just before he left WWE at a Hooters, you know, and said hi to him, and you know, he's a real great guy. He's a real good guy, inside and out.
No. Wasn't he stiff? Did he let it on you wrong, or he didn't like?
Man, he's very professional, man. You could, you know, been doing it for years, so he took care of me, real good.
And I also you also told me, brother, that you wrestled Tracy Smothers, you know, a legend of the Mid South, man. Tracy Smothers, how were those matches, man? With Tracy?
Oh man, they're great, great. He's he'll run you to death in that ring, but you know he's great, man. I have much respect for Tracy. He's a great guy, and just you know somebody I'd hate to cross the path with also, you know. So, but as far as working ability, he's probably one of the best workers in the ring that I've ever faced in my life.
Yeah. That's crazy, man. And you know what? And you know what, Spider? What I noticed about you, Spider, is that you're not scared of heights, brother. Because I remember, I think it was the, I don't know if you were in the first original Carnage Cup. Remember that Carnage Cup? They got shut down. You wrestled a match. I don't know the guy's name, but you guys were on top of the like some balcony, brother. And there was a turn you threw him off, and that was a one crazy fucking spot, man.
It was my buddy Marty Schiffbauer. He's from this area, also. It's supposed to be a Michinoku driver, but when we got up there, I think he kind of, you know, seen how far it was, and it was the table, and so, you know, we split ways on that and come up with that finish right there.
Are you saying he hesitated up there? He got scared?
I guess whole family had showed up that day, and bless his heart, man, I love him to death, and we just got up there and just, you know, I guess he just didn't want to do it. So we come up with the best next thing, and he still went through the table like crazy and hurt his leg. So, you know, I got much respect for him. Always will.
Yeah, but you got to do what you got to do, man. You can't just – I mean, there's people that freeze in the moment, but you got to go through. You got to do something. Not like a bitch up there, you know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
So what do you got coming up next, Spider, for you, man? What do you got coming up around your area? You any death matches, anything coming up, anything big?
Not as death matches wise, but I'm working with this fed from Florence named NGW, and they're having a hardcore show, you know, and I guess I'm going to try to do the best I can as close to a death match as I can on it, so.
So, I mean, if it's not death matches, this is like a false count anywhere, like a hardcore match, something like that.
Yeah, it'll be me and the guy. His name's Jesse Powers. We've did about 3 or 4 matches, and they've been pretty brutal. And, you know, he's the one I come off the roof onto a van with, so.
That's the one you that you are on, or that's another guy? Okay.
Jesse, he's the one that come off, the same one who come off the roof onto a van.
So you were in a roof, and then what'd you do, like a moonsault, like a
it was a Michinoku driver onto a van with him.
Fuck, man, that's crazy. There you go. And what was this federation at?
It was XVW, the same one I worked.
Viscera.
It was New Jack, it was in Muscle Shoals, Alabama.
Okay.
They have closed down now, and there's a little fed here in Florence that me and him's gonna work at probably. Give it one last good ruha, you know.
That's crazy, man. So, what was I tell you? So, freaking, you had all these injuries. Really quick, but can you tell me any ribs or really sick crazy things have you done in your past? Like, say, like you're going in a row with a freak show. Anybody? What's the craziest thing you ever done, man?
Oh, man, the usual. Just, you know, you try to sleep, and if the guy's driving don't want you to sleep, they turn up the radio, you know, put it on static, you know, just a resident. Nothing really. We was all close-knit. Me and I call him Berg. He used to be called Iceberg. He was Freak Show. So me and Show, you know, we've been around, but, you know, just the usual backstage. Not really much has ever really occurred with me like that.
You've done some good hardcore death matches with Freak Show too, huh? You guys had a long feud before, huh?
Oh man, me and him was back in 2002, 2003, 4 and 5. You know,
you guys were doing Freak Shows, I heard.
Yeah, so we go way back, yeah.
Yeah, I remember he was telling me you guys were doing Freak Shows before a lot of people were doing them. You know what I mean?
Yeah, we was going pretty hard at it. He's a good guy, and I love him to death, man. I do anything in this world for him. So yeah.
All right, brother. You know, it's a 30-minute show, brother. It was a good pleasure having you on. You have any contacts where people, the fans, or any promoters can get a hold of you, man? Can you give out your information?
Just my Facebook, Spider Boudreaux Facebook, man.
So it's facebook.com/SpiderBoudreaux. Can you spell it out for the people? Because some people, you know, some people maybe won't know it. You know what I mean?
Okay, it's SpiderBoudreaux. ODROOW.
All right, bro. That's good. All right, Spider, it was a pleasure having you, man. You know, I give you mad respect. I popped for the fucking Exacto knife on the fucking on the arm, man. I give you my keep on doing what you're doing, brother. I mean, I'm a defense worker myself, and I got respect for what you did, man. And who gives a fuck what anybody says, brother. You know, if you, like I like to say, if you're in hardcore, you ain't shit. You know what I'm saying, brother?
That's right, man. Hey, and I appreciate it, brother.
All right, man. Well, it was a pleasure having you on, man. And we'll talk to you next time, man.
All right, man. Take care.
All right. And that was Spider Boo on with us, man. And he's a good guy, man. It's an honor having Spider on, and it was cool and everything. I know we have it's about 8:22 out here in the West Coast. We got a couple more minutes into the show. So next week, fans, you got to join us, Ultraviolent Radio, that we have Chaos, former XPW television champion, on with us. You know, and he was in, you know, WSW and, you know, Wrestling Society X, you know what I mean? He's been everywhere, you know what I mean? He's the head trainer of the Santino Bros Wrestling Academy. And you gotta come in, and we're going to talk about death matches. We're going to talk about April 9th as we do the memorial show. Back to the 80s for my trainer, rest in peace as well, Mr. 80s Dynamite D. So join us next Wednesday as we have Chaos and we talk about death matches and we talk about Dynamite D. And also, don't forget to follow us on Facebook / Ultraviolent Radio. That's Facebook / Ultraviolent Radio. And just, you know, add us and see who we have every show. And just join us next week, Ultraviolent Radio, as we have Chaos and we talk about death matches and back to the 80s, Dynamite D. So join us next week, Ultraviolent Radio for Life. Facebook / Ultraviolent Radio. Thank you very much. Ultraviolent for Life.